I want to say that this incident in the Suez Canal is viewed as some sort of incident which is out of the normal way of how things are done. But in practice, the global supply and production chain is extremely vulnerable. The experts say that the incident in the Suez Canal could have been much worse. For instance, the collision could have taken place upriver towards the Suez port, where the banks are not made of sand but of rock, and could have damaged the ship. It could have been. It could have taken place in November or December, when, because of the holiday seasons, the maritime transport picks up even more, and at the same time, there are worse weather conditions. But I would like to point out the fact that the incident now in the Suez Canal is not the only incident affecting the global supply and production chain today. We have multiple incidents at the same time all over the world affecting a system which more and more seems to be very fragile. And I will give just a few examples. For instance, ever since the winter wave in the United States, especially in Texas, there has been a problem with the supply of plastics and resins in the world, affecting producers in many countries, especially in the US, which rely on plastic supplies. So that is also a problem of supply and of transport. At the same time, we have seen that there is a semiconductor shortage because of the rebound in the production of automobiles. And prior to that, the fabricators of semiconductors had oriented themselves towards other markets. And we see that Toyota, that Volkswagen, Fiat Chrysler have had to reduce production or to shift production because they could not get enough semiconductors to produce the automobiles. At the same time, another very interesting phenomenon, because of the pandemic, the global supply system has become much more inefficient. For one thing, there was a rebound in consumption, while at the same time, the pattern of consumption has changed. This means that there was more and more pressure on the existing supply chain. The factories in China had to produce more and deliver more. This has led to situations where in the United States, the lead times to wait for merchandise from China to arrive to the United States has gone from 30 days or a few weeks to more than 2 months. It is a veritable shortage of container space. Why? Because the Chinese are paying a premium to get containers coming back even empty towards China so they can export their goods. And this has caused a crisis in the capacity of the transport of other goods, including foodstuffs, to markets around the world. At the same time, also because of the pandemic, there is a problem with offloading ships in ports. There is a problem with having enough trucking capacity in order to move the containers. For one of these huge container ships, you need 8,000 trucks just to be able, truck movements, just to be able to offload them. So this means that at every step of the way in the supply and production chain worldwide, we can see stressors appearing here and there. And when these stressors align, we can see a very, very big incident. One of these stressors took place in the Suez Canal, where 13% of global trade takes place. It goes through that canal. And because of the plans of the Egyptian authorities to widen the canal, its capacity is predicted to double by 2023 compared to 2014. So this is very interesting. And in the area of critical infrastructure protection, we work with a concept called normal accidents. These are accidents that take place because of the inherent complexity and fragility and the couplings of an infrastructure system. What happened in the Suez Canal, although regrettable, is not a one-in-a-lifetime chance or something extraordinary. It is something that we would classify as a normal accident, something that you would expect would happen. And if this takes place, as Professor Aiko also said, if this takes place in multiple areas at the same time, if there is an effect in one part of the world affecting the other part of the world, we can have significant damages. And this is because more and more we have become dependent on not just on the global production and supply chains, but on 100% functioning global and production and supply chains. Why? Because we are dependent on just-in-time inventory management to reduce the costs of holding stock. So this means that companies do not have enough parts on hand to continue production if deliveries are curtailed for a week or two. They do not have enough merchandise to satisfy their current customers for the next week or two. Why? Because this entails a cost. So I believe that this incident in the Suez Canal should be a wake-up call that we need to understand the threats coming not just from hackers or from state agents, but the threats stemming from the complexity of the system itself, and moving from there to include the security considerations into the business calculations of the companies and of the private sector in general. Otherwise, we will find out what it means not just to not have enough plastics or to not have enough goods to sell. We might find out what it means to not have enough pharmaceutical products, to not have enough foodstuffs, or to not have enough energy. Thank you very much.